Your assistant doesn't believe, right? Do you think that's a quarter of a...
No. Can I feel the east? No, that's east.
Rise like the east.
The ingredient that turns flour and water into risen bread is yeast, a primitive single-cell fungus. Commercial yeast is dormant when dry, but when it meets water, it wakes up hungry. So it gets warmer and warmer, and as it gets warmer, it starts multiplying and making all these bubbles really fast. But when it finally hits 140, which is pretty hot, but pretty cool, then it dies.
Yes. So first, it's flat in the pot like this, and then it sort of gets a little up. And then it gets a bigger lump, and then it gets a bigger lump, and then it gets a bigger lump, bigger lump, until you put it, and then you put it in the oven, and then it gets even bigger, and then it finally dies. Because it's so big, and it's getting so close to the heat, that the heat burned it, but it's still in that shape. It just dies in that shape. It just keeps in that shape.
All right, now what you're eating. How much water?
Well, the water's not going right now, Nancy. First, we have to add all the dry things together. Sugar. Half a teaspoon.
Sugar makes the... There you go. Now you can do half. Sugar makes the yeast work faster. Half.
I know.
Perfect.
That gives the dough a little sweet.
It makes the yeast work harder.
Then of course the salt. So I don't know what that is, but salt.
We need
a half teaspoon. Man, we're using a lot with this teaspoon, aren't we, everyone?
What'd you just do?
I just put in a cup of water.
All right, now can you read a third backwards? Here it says one half, read those lines. So one third is the middle. Okay, so we'll do the third. So there's a little more over here.
No, that's enough.
It's not a third.
No, that's more than a third.
There, now it is a third. Okay.
No, that's more than a third.
No, it's not.
Listen to me, I see the thing. That's more than a third.
The third is the line in the middle.
You're right. A bossy chef in the kitchen.
I know.
Because she's doing it wrong.
They are like a baker. This is the ugly side of baking.
Right.
Take this off. This is when the chefs get to get messy. The recipes came from Jim Lahey. He's very funny. To prove that, this thing cracked me up a lot. I have other things that I really want to show you guys. From Z to Y, this is from Z to Y. I really liked this soup. Oh my goodness. I've like had a soup like this, but when I saw this recipe, it made me think of good foods and only good foods. It made me think of the best things I would ever eat. And I have another thing to say about him. His bread is the best bread you will ever have in your whole entire life. Actually, you can go and try his food yourself at the Sloan Street Bakery. And if you want to take a class, you can go to class on the same street that I said. Well, the timer is off now, and I think our dough is ready! Ow! Ooh, ah, ooh, ah! Spider-Man.
You guys have got to go outside.
You're changing this?
Come on!
See? Well, you see, I have this dough because I took it out of the pan. And now I'm going to have dough. First, I'm going to squish it up into this so it has a little bow. You see how it looks like it has a basket? And then I'm going to put it back in, and then I'm going to roll it up, and then I'm going to just put it in the middle. Just keep on flatting it down.
I guess we should practice this. Pull! That's it. That's what you want. Pull. Pull. Pull.
Are we ever going to throw it up in the air?
You'll throw it up in the air and then... Right now.
Well, as you can see, I have Italian red sauce. I have mountain capers, I have spicy sardines, and
anchovies.
Spicy anchovies. And I have red peppers. And I also have olives, which are only here, and I might add some sun-dried tomatoes. So let's get cooking. Tomato salad, tomato love, tomato everything, tomato. Now I'm putting cheese on the pizza. Cheese. We love cheese. I love cheese. A lot of people don't think anchovies are yummy, but I think they're delicious. And actually, I'm not the only one. There are lots more out there, but for example, my friend Imogen, she is a salt fiend. So she really likes anchovies because anchovies have a lot of salt.
You're putting it really pretty onto the pizza.
I know, right? And now I'll put a little of this olive oil, this spicy olive oil. It's gonna make the pizza really, really tasty. Actually, let me get a spoon for that.
That's salt.
It's not salt. It's olive oil. Just a little that over there. Yes, exactly. It's gonna be a yummy pizza. I'm hoping that Chris Pizza will turn out like I predict to be a yummy, yes, a spicy yet satisfying dish. And I just hope I can eat the whole pizza. That's another thing I'm hoping.
Beautiful.
It's important to make this has to have a good design because I think that if you design a pizza like a happy face, then it will make you eat happy. So what I'm doing right now actually is making a happy face. You might be able to see it through the camera from a high shot, high angle shot. Food is, in how I think of food, is art, really. And this is not a fake thing. I really think of art, food as art. Pizza's ready! Pizza, 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 pizza party! Yeah! Now I want you guys to see if you think this is ready.
It's bubbling.
It must be.
Drawn at the edges.
Nice warm pizza on a cold winter night. For the final test, we have to see what Billy Boy thinks.
Oh, thank you so much. Oh my goodness, pizza. Duh, pizza. Well, that's a really good pizza. Oh wow, that's great.
Now it's time for the pizza party. Thank you for helping me, Nancy. And Bill, thank you for being our tester and eating up our pizza so fast and showing that you really love it. Now, time for the pizza party. No!